Who's me? Well, I'm just a targeted individual. I'm nothing. Don't worry about it. It'll never happen to you. Your mind won't be read. You won't have your children's lives be threatened. Don't worry about it. It'll never happen to you. This government loves everyone. You'll never have it. Don't just turn away. Run. You won't be attacked. Your brain's not being monitored right now like mine. So now they're threatening me on that corner of that building, I hear. So whatever beam they shoot at to transfer a voice to that corner of that beam, or in my head from an angle from the sky, you know, it's working really swell right now because they got a clear connection. Better than a cell phone. Better than my cell phone. And you know it's from a distance. Because they're threatening my children right now. Big time.
Why is your hand over your eye?
Because I'm a devil worshiper. What are you talking about?
The Illuminati. They're forming the new world order.
Solid 6.
The United States of America has separated itself from everything pure, from the violent video games, the illicit drug sales, the vulgar embracing of morally inept codes of ethics, the never-ending propaganda and lies. The United States has changed from a once pure nation to a nation under pagan power. Has the United States repudiated its Constitution? As of June the 2nd, 2011, the U.S. Supreme Court ruled that police can violate the Fourth Amendment of the United States Constitution against unreasonable search and seizure under circumstances where they believe that evidence is being destroyed. This gives the police the discretion to manufacture a pretext or an excuse to, quote, kick in the door without a search warrant, said dissenting judge Ruth Bader Ginsburg of the Vague New Standard. Ginsburg said that new rulings give the police a, quote, way to routinely dishonor the constitutional requirement that they obtain a warrant by manufacturing an exception to it. Determining when the police don't violate the constitutional protection against unreasonable search by barging in already has exceptions for exigent circumstances. Emergencies like an imminent risk of death or danger that evidence will be destroyed. But the urgency usually exists when the police arrive at the scene. In this case at hand, the police caused the circumstances themselves.
I have two words for you. Predator drones. You will never see it coming. You think I'm joking?
Yes, our president has a hit list of American citizens like you targeted for assassination. Now, I want you to imagine George W. Bush had a hit list of Americans targeted for assassination. This president does, and there are indications that the list of Americans targeted for assassination is growing. The CIA's list included three people, apparently, just a few months ago, but in a recent interview with the Washington Times, President Obama and his top terrorism advisor, John Brennan, said there are dozens of U.S. citizens around the world that are, quote, very concerning to the administration. But as Salon.com's Glenn Greenwald puts it, Brennan's statement suggests that the president's battlefield powers extend everywhere, even to places where there is actually no combat whatsoever. And joining us now, Salon.com's Glenn Greenwald. Glenn, are we, how do you interpret this? I won't even subject you to a bunch of questions. If you look at this, is this as bad as it appears?
It's probably worse than it appears. I mean, look at the controversies that were created during the Bush administration when the president got caught spying on American citizens without warrants or trying to detain them without due process. Here you're talking about something far more extreme. You're talking about targeting American citizens for murder, for assassination, based merely on the allegation that they're involved in terrorism. No evidence, no charges, no trial, nothing. And it's extraordinarily dangerous, especially when you consider the fact that when allegations of terrorism by the government are subjected to judicial review, in overwhelmingly high percentages of the cases, 72%, courts find that the allegations are without merit. So who would ever justify allowing the president to target American citizens for assassination without any judicial oversight or charges or due process of any kind?
The Obama administration's acknowledged it's continuing a Bush-era policy, authorizing the killing of U.S. citizens abroad. The confirmation came from Director of National Intelligence Dennis Blair in congressional testimony last week.
Good evening from New York. President Obama has reportedly authorized the death penalty for an American citizen who has not been convicted of any crime, the evidence against whom has yet to see the light of day, who denies his guilt, and who has not been given the due process, including trial, guaranteed by the Constitution of the United States. It is a power not even claimed by the Bush-Cheney administration, extending far beyond Bush-Cheney claims.
Public service citizens alert I'm putting out in regards to remote EEG, remote neural monitoring, and brain and pathway tracking. Mapping the thought process via remote devices. I've talked a little bit about this before, but I want to get into the actual meaning of it. In concordance with energy and remote weapons, radio frequency, voice to skull, brainwave mapping allows trackers and stalkers to actually reverse your memory and your thought patterns, and during your sleep, in your subconscious mind, actually probe your memory banks and the memory banks of others around you or others that have known you to obtain information that you might find yourself wondering just how they obtain that stuff that you may not have even thought of in years. It really is amazing, the capability of these new technologies. Of course, they're available through programs, computer applications, phone applications can be delivered via phone. Let's not forget Gwen Towers, the higher-ups, NSA, CIA, PsyOps intelligence groups. Brainwave mapping is the ultimate in brain policing.
And keep it rolling.
Okay, we are on the air, by the way, I hope. I hope it's not hot air, at least not from the standpoint of people's time that's important. Our time's important. Actually, the short time that we're on this planet is important, especially the type of time that we spend here is more important, especially if we've not spent the right kind of time that was important, maybe even to us, if we had a right to be anything important, especially in a system that doesn't seem to think of us as anything but not a, let's say, a target. Is that important? Are we being targeted? How important is all of our lives? Or maybe to us we are, but maybe to things or people or elements or departments or corporations and banks and syndicates, even heads of religious orders and stuff like that. The only thing that what we may be important to them is not the same importance to us. I am Wilkie Wilson. This is the All Day Live Show, and I do appreciate everybody if you're going to take the time to listen and share, and even find out maybe that not only all of us are important, because this is Community Access TV. I think everything that we're trying to do, the time that we don't have on this planet, is of extreme importance, especially the time that we may not have much longer. And we need to think about that. And we need to also think about the fact that other people have points of view. In the meantime, why don't we share our points of view? We have some people here in the studio. I am Will P. Wilson, and that's Alex. Alex, thanks for being here. That's James Loss. And then we have Pat Shoup. Pat, you there?
Yes, I am.
Okay, we have Patricia Shoup, host of Call for Investigation. And Pat, I appreciate you also calling in from where you're at, Arkansas. I bet that's
mm-hmm.
a... And yeah. I know that what kind of the topic we're going to cover, as we've talked, called a lot, because Pat has hosted and produced the Call for Investigation program here in the Northwest on Public Access, which was scanned and now Seattle Community Media, for 12, 14 years, Pat, right? And
Working on that, yeah.
And in that same time period, you've tried to cover a lot of truth. Truth, I think, is of the most importance. And Pat, as far as you're having to deal with this system, we've all been targets all kinds of different ways, right? I mean, am I
wrong? Oh, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So many different ways. It filled several volumes of books, not just one. But it's, you know, what good does it do to concentrate on that? You need to get the work done, because if we don't, we won't be accomplishing anything, and how worthwhile is our time on Earth?
Pat, we have Alex is here. Alex, it's really good to see you. And we also have James Loss also here. But real quick, and I can bring James Loss. James, it's good to see you. And I'll bring you up here if you got anything to say. It's good to see you also. We have a panel. It's only going to be a brief show. Alex, psychotronic warfare, even tied into chemtrails, you name it, goes on. But the thing is, if we don't talk about it as a community, we're silent. We have at this rare opportunity, as I've tried to get the young people in Seattle, Washington, to wake up and try to say, look, you've got the ability to have communications, and they don't see it. The people here in the Northwest aren't taking the classes to learn how to produce their own community TV. We're going brain dead as a people, and we're failing to realize certain things and certain Whoa. Gifts and blessings. And why? What's going on?
Okay.
And if we don't keep us being seen and heard, then silence can make any type of destiny or destroy it, whatever it is. But I'm saying I don't hide behind rocks like a lot of the people that have the capability to hide behind rocks and basically throw rocks at us at the same time. You know, we have to realize a lot involved. Pat, am I wrong? I mean, we've had rocks thrown at us in all kinds of different ways.
Oh, yeah. It goes on and on. But most of the ones doing so think that they're doing it for national security. And which is a real shame, because they don't know what's actually happening. That's why I keep saying to the intel agents, you must know the full picture of what you're doing how it fits in and how much damage you're doing in doing it. So.
Yeah, that's incredible, Pat. Alex, what's your thoughts real quick? I mean, so we can...
Well, you know. Don't you get the whole design of when they originally, a couple years ago, when they shut down the main, station for, public access? You had kids coming in there, and it was like a community, but that was the whole design of, people like Paul Allen and Bill Gates, who try to perpetrate that they're peace-loving, peace, love, and New World Order, more like it, killing people with Ebola, but okay, whatever. And so what you have is you have people, as we talked about earlier, they only care about their iPods. They only care about their TV, their favorite TV show, and they're very antisocial. And when these things are tailored just for you with the digital TVs, why do you need to talk to anybody when you can sit at home and talk to your TV, interact with your TV, interact by your cell phone, all communications that are being, tracked, but we're sheeple in units as the elite think we are. So that's what we act, because we give them a reason to want to control us and to corral us to use mind control weapons like Woodpecker that's been being used since 1977. But again, everybody's sleeping, we're just all crazy, but it all just keeps happening like some sick scary dream when we're talking. That's what it is. But if you tell them about recycling in Seattle, or if you talk about child molesters here or the ecosystem, then they're having protests, they're over here trying to start a meeting about that or get on TV about that. But the things that are controlling our environment, like all the red, new hybrid buses that have no windows, but have air vent systems so they can poison us all and we can't open the windows, and all the buses are 666. But nobody's paying attention to that. And the cops that are getting on the bus, which I told you what they were going to start doing when they started their little, we're just trying to make sure we get all the fare, yet you can have little fancy things on the side of the road, little bus stops on the side of the road that cost thousands of dollars, but you're going broke. And the cops are getting on the bus, like I predicted, and they're asking for your ID, and they're taking you to jail. But people like Bill Cooper, Alex Jones, and Will P. Wilson are crazy when they've been telling you about this new world order, and you're so brainwashed, you just think it's because they're collecting fare. No, why, if they've been collecting everybody's fare, why are they still broke? Well, and why do they need to discontinue other bus lines?
Well, who are
what's
the buses,
going on?
Who actually licenses those buses, and who?
Well, it is Metro, and you notice every time, every year, they don't have no money. But they have money. Hey, do you guys know that Metro actually gets their little fare enforcers from a temporary service? Do you know that they're paying that temporary service at least $30 an hour? But they can't hire people, but they're broke. They can buy new buses, but they're broke. Do you see what's going on with this new world order and these Metro buses? They can afford fancy bus stops that talk to you and light up, but they're broke.
You're right.
Listen, wake up, people.
Pat, what's your thoughts on that? I mean, to Alex, I know.
It's in our face.
I know, and they do need to hear it. They do need
they
to
do.
Hear it.
Hello, wake up.
I agree. Pat, go ahead.
Well, with their constantly being broke is that just a ploy. What we have found when we've gone through the different accounting, the proprietary accounts, very intriguing. And why don't they even... return funds, in the so-called unclaimed. It goes all together. They are after the money. Then just the whole portion of they're trying to go after you for fines and so on, it's just all about the money. It's literally an extortion racket if the attorneys were doing their job right. But then they're too busy listening to the Bar Association. So what is all gained by what they're doing? Well, power and control. That's at the very focus of it, but there's a definite agenda behind what they're doing. And when they try to say through their psychotronics, through the TV, the suggestion of why they want to fluoridate it so you're not thinking clearly, is that you are supposed to just follow your orders. And what orders and why? Well, it goes back to satanic interests. And if people see it for what it is, you'll sort out this mess a whole lot faster because that pyramid structure is in place for definite reasons, and they're using everything in their power to keep you below that top of the pyramid, and basically they can just trot on you and do anything they want to. And they literally make you ridicule the very ones who are trying to help you the most. Now, what's the purpose of it? Well, not just the power and control. That's a big thing right there. But if you get into the nitty-gritty of what is going on, what is their agenda, why the entire code that they use, including the Georgia Guidestones, and they have a whole plan being worked out. As far back as 1999, they had millions of body bags, and they had the one scare after another. They've gotten the coffins since then, and a lot of preparations for a huge die-off. Now, what real purpose is that? Well, decrease the surplus population and useless eaters, supposedly, but there's actually more to it. It's a spiritual reason behind it, and of course, if you get into the spiritual, then you get into the ridicule factor, and thus the psychotronics help you not see the full picture. And if all people that need to, you, for your own future, need to start seeing how what you say to someone else, and if there's a ridicule, if somebody else is ridiculing you, you need to see why are they doing it. What is the real purpose behind it? Because until we start straightening this mess out, we're not going to get anywhere just pointing fingers at each other. But if we see what needs to be done, we can get it done, of course, and that's why they don't want you to think. All the more reason you need to very clearly think through your position, what you're doing, how you're doing it, how it affects others.
Pat, I was going to mention really quick here, if I can hear myself even, which I'm not listening to myself. My mic's not working. It's moving around like a crazy. It's amazing. If people couldn't hear me earlier, I apologize for that. The equipment's very old here at the North Seattle. Anyway, now I hope you can hear me. But anyway, so Pat, in the same perspective of that, the targeting, this is just my perspective, and as it mentioned that, you know, Obama now, the eavesdropping is a lot more than just eavesdropping. Mm. It ties into cloud computing, as we've mentioned about, you know, Tableau cloud computing over here in the east side of Seattle, the neuroeconomic processes, it ties into Promega, look it up. These international operations are tied into neural research of humans, which means that it's not just listening to cell phones and tapping it, it's tapping us. It's tapping our DNA, it's tapping our thoughts. And then it goes beyond that, and then it also does a full phase loop and comes back to us, so it's looping through us, and then it's more or less how do we control us in a society. Now, if you haven't noticed, if you are alive, Pat and Alex, that we are a system now almost completely becoming robotically controlled. And people don't even, I ask myself, when I get on a bus here in Seattle, most of them, I ask them, how do they even get their socks on in the morning? What do they do? And if you sit and I look at myself, or think about myself, I'm thinking, they're all texting. What did they make today? Do they produce anything? What are we becoming? Alex, you know?
Okay, have you ever seen the movie Idiocracy with, I believe it's Matt Wilson, it's one of the Wilson brothers? And basically, instant, this guy, you know, his name is Dax Shepard is the actor, and he is totally just brain mush, and he sits in a chair all day with a tube in his mouth, and he poops in this chair, and it's in the future, and guess what? The president happened to have been black in the movie. This was way before Obama was elected, and he watches TV all day, and he does nothing but poop, fart, suck on a straw, and he sounds like a caveman. Do you not even get that this movie was invented by the elite and they were making fun of us? They're calling us mush mind sheep, dumb idiots, dope heads, retarded, below the measure of with all the fluoride and all the stuff they're putting in the food, the Soylent Green and the aspartame. You wonder why you got seizures? Stop drinking Coca-Cola and Pepsi and all of this stuff. This is how they're controlling us. Wait. This is why it's easy, the nanobots and all of this that Will is so wonderfully talked about.
Alex,
and Patricia.
You could tell them for the rest of time, don't use fluoride toothpaste. Go somewhere.
I don't even use it anymore. I stopped using it about 8 months ago after hearing it.
It's not about you or me. It's about everyone else and them. And they won't change. And if you tell them it's in the water, they don't. It's like they're so dumbed down now that they're not even capable of understanding that.
The movie Idiocracy. Watch it. Great movie.
Yes.
You'll see America the way the elite are trying to do America.
You're right. Pat, go ahead.
Yeah, what was amazing to me years ago, made a trip to Portland, Oregon, and I noticed that there was so much more vibrance and alertness to the people, and I asked a person that lived in Portland, what is the difference? And he said, very simple, we're not dumb enough to have fluoride in our water. It was that visible, folks. And if you think that it doesn't accumulate, dream on. It does.
Yeah.
It just gets worse and worse.
Yeah. Yeah.
And when it gets worse, you don't understand. You know, other people also. Some of the audience that are actually listening to this, we're kind of preaching to the choir, but others don't even see that because it's insidious. It's like the frog in the pot, you know, just little by little by little. And it really shows up.
Yeah, you're right, Pat. And Alex, you're seeing things. That's, you're an investigative journalist. And what you mentioned about these buses, how many people, I wouldn't have thought about it.
Well, they got, look, you know it's the elite. Look, they've got this system on there because they believe in Apollo, Apollyon. They're awaking the Apollyon, which is Lucifer, from the pit. And if you really think about it, on the bus, there's camera systems you get on, and it says Apollo system.
Yeah.
Now, if these are not, and the A looks like a conveniently nice triangle at the top. Now, if these people in the New World Order, now look, people, you're going to get people in, oh, my God, this Illuminati, you know, stop listening to Mark Dice. He's an idiot. You tell anybody that these people are puke, gross-sucking, ritualistic, satanic freaks, and then you say, oh, well, they don't do any witchcraft, and these conspiracy people are crazy. This is Mark Dice. He's an idiot. He's double-talking. He's a disinformation person. If you say that they're scum-sucking, ritualist, satanic, then don't they do rituals? Don't they kill people? That would make sense if you're saying it, Mark Dice. Just shut up. You're killing off all the good Christians and all the truth conspiracists. But anyways, that's what's going on, Will.
Yeah, well, that is Mark Dice in the background, and actually he's done some incredible stuff.
Yes,
very
but
simple.
Have you heard him when he's saying one thing and then he turns around and then he calls all conspiracy people, even that means even you, Will, he calls them idiots, crazy, but you're saying the Illuminati's real and you're saying that Miley Cyrus is a Illuminati prostitute, ritual, satanic slut. But then you're saying conspiracy people are crazy and they don't kill babies and they're not doing rituals and they're not saying this, but you're saying this, he's a disinformation. He might do some work, but he's been bought out. And they obviously proposition him like they did Alex Jones, because Alex Jones sits there and throws up triangles.
We've only got about 5 minutes left. And what do you got? What?
CDC, forget about the show last week, about the colloidal silver and what I told you, Will.
Yeah.
Those two news flashes. When we get time, if I can get at least a minute to do that, I can do that in a minute.
We can't.
Patricia.
Okay, Pat, go ahead real quick. We'll get one input for last input. We can do it in your last second. So, go ahead.
Yeah, well, what people need to take into consideration is why is this all going around, happening the way it is? And what you can do about it, and you can do a lot if you decide to wake yourself up, get off the fluoridated water, make sure that you do not brush with fluoride toothpaste, to clean out your system, detoxify. We have a book out on how to, you know, be healthy. We need to get some of these copies out, and we need people reading them and passing this information on. We can even cure autism now. We've got some tremendous progress happening, and we can shut off their psychotronics if we work together.
They have proven that autism.
Alex, real quick, you were going to mention about
comment 1 second. I got several things about a newscast that we came up with, me and Will, last week, but the whole thing is Patricia, a top CDC whistleblower, had already had said and came out a couple months ago that the MMR shots, if given before 36 months, have been proven to cause autism, and especially high retardation in young black boys and in Hispanic boys, just to comment on that. So there was a couple things that we talked about last week on Will's show last week. One thing we didn't talk about, what we did, was the CDC and the owning the patent. Well, apparently the Federal Register's office, now get online, the Federal Register's office, for all you people who say we're all crazy, check it out for yourself, but you won't because you're sheeple. There is a patent on the Ebola, rabies, filio vaccine to mix Ebola, rabies, and filio virus. A grant has been approved by the Federal Register Office for the CDC to own this. So why do they need to mix this? The next thing, natural news. We talked about last week, World Health Organization moves to ban colloidal silver, because we already said it's working for the Ebola virus. From West Africa, they're moving against governments. Thousands of people are left ill from being denied colloidal silver in West Africa, also banning vitamin C and vitamin B12 shots. Natural remedies do work.
Truly amazing.
Isn't it?
That is, that they're covering it up, and the fact that they've got five other...
the CDC.
So they're mutating it as fast as they can. Obviously.
Yeah, but why do we need a rabies... yeah. Filio,
yeah.
You know, Ebola, yeah. Shot, when rabies is rare, and they want to shoot us up with the stuff. See, people, hello, bah, wake up.
And also take note, we need people to help us get more messages out, so help us on that one, too. Come down here and learn. And if you want to donate to me, I'll put the information at the bottom of the screen before the end of the show. But James Loss, real quick, give me some input. You're here in the set, and I appreciate you being here. And you have some input real quick? Go ahead.
Yeah, the homeless is still homeless.
Yeah, I can't hear you, but I mean, tell us PSKS, right?
Still homeless out here in Seattle, people.
If I can get the information up down here, there you are.
Well, you can
see it's PSKS down at the bottom of the screen, right there. You guys got that, James? Thanks. You've done a lot for 20 years, over more than that, and you're one of the only people in the state here in the city that's actually done something. Most of these guys get paid well, and that's it. They get paid well, talk well. That's about it. But anyway, more input later, psks.org. Get a hold of James if you can. If you can use your help as well as donations. Thank you, James. Alex, appreciate it. Pat Shoup, real quick, give us one last statement.
Well, people, don't think that you're alone on things, and make sure that you realize how much you could do to help yourself and others around you. Just do not listen to someone who has a lot to gain by ridiculing someone. Listen to the evidence. Don't pay any attention other than what is really happening. And help yourself, because you can. And we will help each other as if we simply participate.
Hey, everybody. Thanks a lot for watching All Day Live this week and next week. And wherever you can watch us online at archive.org, type in All Day Live. You can go to seattlecommunitymedia.com or .org or whatever. Watch us anytime you want to, actually. But please hear me out. We're losing touch with reality if we don't start teaching young people to learn to become the future media professionals. And no one seems to care. But that's the reach around the world. And are we becoming so brain dead as a people?
Yes.
And forgetting anything, and not realizing
but
that
isn't
the slender...
that what Nazi Germany did?
Yep.
They took control of the children's minds,
right.
And that is what is going on. They don't want anybody outside of their rat cage unless you belong to a lineage or a bloodline, or unless you're willing to sell your soul. Than that, we're sheeple and units. What they think you are, and that's when you don't research and look at and take the websites,
yep.
And you dismiss. And you're like, oh, the media's right. Oh, this and that. Okay, you flip on the news, people. 666.
Anyway,
all the news is the same.
Thank you very
Good
much,
night.
Alex. Thank you greatly. I appreciate it. Thank you, James. Thank you, Pat. Thank you, everybody. Pat, thank you from Arkansas.
Thanks.
And we'll see
you
on the next week of the next week and the next week. Hopefully, I can keep saying that and not get weak saying it. Okay? I appreciate it. All Day Live, Will P. Wilson. See you next week.
I'm just a homeless person.
What's that?
I'm just a homeless person. You were harming me with something.
Harming you?
Yeah. You were harming me.
Morning news
in
the parking
lot as well.
News and on-scene
what
report.
Makes you
on
so special?
Let's go back to the scene now for the very latest. Morning news on Como News.
Excuse me? Now, so they have this particle beam. The Loomis guys have a particle beam. And then at the end of their shift, they use it on a person?
No, what they do is they take the information back to the lab.
Take what information?
From the particle beam.
But I mean, so this particle beam, are they shooting it at people?
You know, what it does is it takes the brainwave information and then it stores it.
The brainwave information.
Yeah.
But I mean, don't particle beams will take the particle beams will actually have a reaction on a person. Do you realize that? The particle beam. I can tell you right now that there's a book that you need to read. It's called Dr. Mary's Monkey. And they use the particle beams to try to mutate viruses and bacterias. But I had no idea they were using the particle. So they're using the particle beam to read people's brainwaves? Is that what you said?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what they're using it for right now.
Oh, I can tell you right now. Why are they having Loomis do this? These people aren't medical people.
They got the contract from the government.
They got the contract from the Department of Justice?
From the government.
Is it from JustNet?
From the government.
Do you know which area it is? Is it from the Department of
Justice? Area 51.
Area 51?
Yeah.
You're kidding! Oh my God, okay. Oh my God, thank you. But let me just say this about that. It hurts, I don't want to really say my name, you know, it hurts, it hurts very much. This really hurts when they do that. And let me say this about that, they cause damage and mutations, and we die from this. Do you understand?
Yeah.
What right do they have to do this to me and my car? That's what the government says, to go pick out homeless people and do this to them?
Yeah, especially if you're driving a foreign car.
If you're driving a foreign car? Well, I have an old Ford. So tell him I'm, you know, not to pick on people in old Fords.
Okay.
You know, I mean, so they hit me on the back of my head, right?
Oh, this is the next one.
And but then they came back and they hit me in my heart. What was that for? Why did they do that?
So they hit you in your heart with the particle beam?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah, they came.
The only reason that I think that they would do that is to make sure that you would be strong enough to withstand the pain. But I'm not sure.
Oh, you know, that, it, can you imagine?
What's up with them tonight?
Yeah.
This is from the Seattle area of your Renton?
I'm in the Renton Highlands, and I'm in the same Safeway parking lot, and I don't want them to attack me again tonight.
Okay.
I find this really hard to believe that you have a contract to attack homeless people in foreign vehicles.
Basically, everyone, they have a foreign car or a blue one, because it's a contract from the government. It's a blue car? Blue cars?
I have a white car.
Okay. Well, let me get this. I'm with them, because I have to go through the area 51 phone to make sure that you're alive, okay? To make sure that I'm alive? Yeah, and then we'll tell them to not attack you anymore tonight, okay? Oh, well, anymore tonight, but yeah, in the future I could be attacked. No, we'll let them know to stay away from you, all right? But I mean, this is incredible to me. So may I call you again?
Sure, yeah.
Okay,
yeah, well,
no, my name
is Angelica, and your name is?
My last name is Tan.
Tan? I mean, you know, I did know about the particle beams, but I thought that they were long distance. And then there's the, are you aware of the advanced light source beam? I mean.
Yeah, I wasn't, but you know what, we were looking at that too.
Yeah, because that, they come from the universities and they go across states, you know. They can go anywhere in the world with that, the advanced light source beam. But I had no idea they would do something like, have the, so the Loomis guys are attacking people in foreign cars or blue cars. Man, I'm never getting a blue car. Thanks for the warning.
Yeah, no, that's no problem. But let me talk to them.
Okay, thank you. Oh, thanks. And do you have my phone number?
No.
Okay, well, I'll be calling you again. Awesome. This is the first time I've gotten any truth. It's the first time anybody's told me about the, any of the truth about any of this. Thank you.
Well, that's no problem. Will you take care, okay?
You too. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Bye.
No, that's not the way to do it. Safe way. Well, here they are.
Ron Gilman's house, and this is out in front of Ron's house. Today is September 16. You know, we get a little point of look here. What Ron puts outside is a way of trying to tell the world what he's having to go through. It's not fun being psychotronically targeted as a targeted individual from other slimy scum that work for the inner core of the University of Washington, Microsoft, Boeing, Hewlett Packard, all these major companies, all of them tied to neuroeconomics Yes, I was informed, you know, pro-mega. Now, Tableau Corporation over here in Bellevue. Cloud computing at its best. Went to their conference here a couple of weeks ago at the Seattle Center. They had enough money to buy off the entire center for a night. Portable fencing. Well, 5 to 10,000 people, quite a lot of people, plus all their relatives. But nice people, you know. But they won't give you their full name when I talk to over 50 of them. There, would they give you a business card or even tell you what company they work for? How does that work? Well, you know, it works in their favor. It's the, you know, the rich guy's Masonic cloud computing crime syndicate or from the east side taking over the center for one night. Should have filmed it. You know, nice guys. Well, as long as they get their paychecks and they get compensated. And the money laundering is money laundered back into this country, the hundreds of trillions stolen by the Bush crime family and the Treasury Department for the Rothschilds, you know, and AIPAC and the Israeli Mossad and whoever else is involved with all these crime syndicate operations that they're doing, and mass murder, killing, destroying American people's lives. You know, millions of people being targeted, 8-9 million perpetrators, those are called perps, you know. And so we're dealing with this crime syndicate now that's now going to use all of us for neurotesting, meaning using all kinds of super advanced electronic warfare of all kinds, probably over 30, 40,000 contractors tied to this, also not hardware, but also software, cloud computing software. Try to imagine. Now all these guys are cloud computing. What's that mean? Where does it integrate? What's the whole idea of cloud computing? What are they doing with it? What are they doing with cloud computing? Well, I'm sure it has to get some money coming through for it to exist, right? And here we are. We're still in front of Ron's house. Today is September 16, and here's more of his signs. He's tried to wake people up about what's going on. It's not fun. He's put TVs out in front of his house. He's tried to put a way to get the public's attention. That's why we do these TV shows. And, you know, the whole idea is to be able to try to help at least make a report, meaning a message, we are only messengers, of us being targets. It's not fun, people. We're not part of that East Side Men's Club that, you know, just gathered over at the Seattle Center, Tableau Cloud Computing, and all their subcontractors. I mean, try to imagine what we have to go through continuously and being targeted in all kinds of different ways. Different ways of what? I mean, it goes beyond, let's say, Snowden telling you about, you know, we're eavesdropping on your phone and on your email. It goes way beyond that. It goes way beyond that. It's now they're eavesdropping on your thoughts. They're eavesdropping through your DNA and through their drones, thousands of different types of drones, flying over North Seattle here just this last week. Amazing, isn't it? Just amazing what we have here as a country. Just before the final demise of a country that's waiting to be destroyed. Hopefully this report will be shown on All Day Live. You know, 14 years ago, they stole everything I owned. The people named Vance Boudreau, Michelle Perosk, Terry Heston, Bill Schroeder, Mr. Michael S. Kunath, my first wife, Jennifer Ann Cohn, my second wife and her family, Barbara Ann Brown, Shirley Talley, all of them. Working together with these characters, getting paid well to steal my estate. My two greedy brothers that are still left, other than my oldest brother that died last year, Tug Wilson. Tom Scott Wilson, Mr. Rich Boy, received billions of dollars from my dad, Jack Wilson, John Gould Wilson. All of them prospering while they use me for a target, a mind control target. Isn't this fun? Isn't it fun to be in a world where everybody around you is your enemy? Isn't it neat? Can't you wait to be here tomorrow? And then their technology is so advanced that they can make you go 14 years without even having a woman to talk to here in this outdoor jail cell called Seattle. Not even a woman to talk to, let alone any form of intimacy. That's how powerful their mind control is. They completely control even the people around you. Think about that, everyone. Think about it. This is what's going on in your world today that's being reported on All Day Live by Will P. Wilson. Ain't fun, people. Now that we're being used for experiments before they destroy the entire Earth. I guess so, huh? Boy, what a wake-up call. And a go-to-sleep moment of time, because there isn't much time left, people. Well, on with the rest of this program, All Day Live, Will P. Wilson. And Justice will be played out no matter what you've done to us. It's coming back on you. You characters are going to get it. I don't care what anybody says. It's a living universe. It's not yours. It's a living universe. It belongs to the living universe. This planet ain't yours. The solar system ain't yours. The galaxy ain't yours. And justice will find its way here soon. No matter what you do to us, it's going to find you. Justice will be played out for all you rich, slimy billionaires and millionaires. You filthy, dirty scum that think you are all in charge. It's going to find you soon. The living universe is going to find every one of you for what you did to us, let alone what you did to the American Indian and everyone else. You will be found, all of you. The heads of all the corporations, the Pope's now found guilty for child trafficking. Yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. Watch what's going to happen.
Fuck, I've been fucking calling 911 all day today in these parks. Fucking this technology sucks.
You're watching your car.
My video!
My camera is pointing at my car so I can videotape my car while I slept.
Right.
Because I was getting so many problems with my car.
Right.
And one night, they showed me probably about 12 different people being hunted in the desert.
Right.
In groups of three with a little drone, probably about 4 feet long.
Right.
Was hunting them with a little drone right behind that drone. Taking a picture of him.
Oh, this is in your mind. You saw this.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, I couldn't stop watching it. Jesus Christ.
He intercepted it.
They did.
No, they put it on there for me.
Hold on.
They did.
They intercept the video equipment, and they can overlay imagery on it. So whatever you're recording,
right.
It's magnetic media. It could pick it up.
Okay.
Oh, we just heard from Derek.
Okay. So you watched them actually hunt these people down with
drones? Oh, it's a terrible death, yeah. It's a terrible, terrible way to die. They blow, their brains blow up into a steam eventually, or their chest does.
Oh, they use that weaponry on me.
You would not be here.
They almost blew me up.
Okay,
yes,
well, you would not be there. Their brains steamed. Their soul just burst.
That's right.
Okay, well,
it's the high.
Congratulations for surviving that one.
Well, I can't believe I did. They stopped it.
Right.
Because I said, go ahead, blow my fucking head off. I'm headed to the FBI office now. I've got all my documents with me and my Rolleiter. They could not believe I got up. And they said, why aren't you screaming? I said, I'm screaming. I said, I don't care. You can blow my fucking head off in the FBI office. Maybe then they'll do something.
Yeah, I want to.
And so they knocked me down.
I want a microwave burn.
You have no idea the pain of that?
I have the pain. I've had surgery.
No, no. With your head. When they used the weaponry to, like, they blew off people's heads.
I've had
an aneurysm. Video.
You're right. I don't know the pain. You're right.
Holy shit. Because I've had an aneurysm, too. You smell your squamous cells burning. You smell your teeth.
Oh, you're right.
Burning.
I don't know that one. Oh.
You smell your teeth burning. And the pressure. Oh my God, the pressure on your head, and you smell it. You can smell.
Well, they can produce smell.
No, no, you will smell if you know what. Have you ever smelled burning flesh? Or it's disgusting, you know? The smell of.
God, I want a cigarette. The worst pain I've ever had yet was in between my cleft of my mouth, below my sinus, above my teeth. I felt like I was hit with pepper spray. I was talking like I'm talking to you to my friend. And all of a sudden I had coffee and I went, whoa, I threw the cover and went, what? Like that. And I'm like, what the fuck? I went right to the ER. They did CAT scans and shit. Nothing wrong. I fucking lost it. I lost it.
This is worse. Because
I'm not saying it's not worse.
No, I'm not saying that yours is not.
I just said that was the worst pain. Well, yeah. I mean, my foot being separated was pretty bad.
They did that with, they blew up my feet so much, they tore my flesh. They tore the, what is that called?
Flesh.
What is that called? The tissue? The connective tissue?
Will?
Yeah.
Oh, hey.
You need to meet Penny, and you need to meet, you need to get a hold of these people down there.
Well, that list that you gave me was all 360 numbers, and they're all afraid to talk, apparently.
No, they're not. They're not getting your phone call. They're not getting your phone
call. I'll leave a message, they don't call me back.
How do I explain that?
Or one
person. Well, you know what, Ron, to be fair,
I don't know what you're talking about.
There's been numerous groups of attorneys who have been murdered. Wow. They've all of a sudden dropped dead, and it's been really creepy.
Did you
so they've been very aggressive.
That's on YouTube right now. That's getting targeted. You didn't answer the phone. That's what it was. I kept calling.
Yeah, anybody.
Now
you've had one. I've seen one of the meetings, and actually, I've been going through it all through this meeting, just so everyone knows that.
You're really being hit hard.
Oh my God! Does anybody have Sean?
You can't make this up.
No, wait. Look this way. Trapped against my back.